What's up, guys? This is the Rifleman. I am back bringing you to the next episode of my Empire Total War Let's Play as France. So to round off where we left off, we are engaging the Swedish fleet, which are trying to transit an assault force across the Baltic. So we need to make sure we destroy them entirely, or at least as much as we can. So let's engage them. So I know we have to destroy or capture every possible ship. The escape with their fleet intact, but that's okay. I'd assume we'd be able to chase them down. Okay, so let's put second. Admirals first. So roughly in this formation. Wind. Ooh, that might be actually ideal. If they sail, you probably want to go something like that. So, is there? Are they following? Yeah, they are following a line. What I would very much like is for my ship line to be fairly set up by the time they get into position. And I think we might be in might be able to get a bit of a favourable engagement going on, because they do have the smaller, lighter ships. So I do need to be careful about them. Chopping my formation up. Because that's something with the light ships, they're very capable of doing. But I think you'll notice when the AI does think it has to rely on this tactic of breaking up your formation, they will quite aggressively go for that kind of thing. Which is fair enough, it's part of the AI's prerogative to try to win the game. But I do like what we have going on right now. There is no immediate dash to try and cut my lines. It's forming up more like a conventional sea battle, which I think I will win, because I have such significantly more heavier ships. Although they will eventually intersect my line, but only after a few rounds of trading gunfire. There we go, now the first volleys have been fired. So I probably want to keep turning that sort of direction to stop them from being able to break my line as soon as possible. So they are engaging mine, so Guerrier is going to keep engaging Dr. Lovisa Polorica. For a few shots at range. First ships look like they're not, whether they're trying to break our lines, I don't know. But I'm happy they're at this range, I'll say that much. Because hopefully if we can destroy the head of this fleet, then I'll feel more confident curving them around to face the incoming ships. Okay, so not maybe not such as sweeping of a curve as that, but if they're going to turn into me. Something like this to keep the maximum amount of guns firing on the good doctor. Shot if we're in range, if not, then I'll just switch back to round shot. So let's get these guys to set to chain shot because hopefully they will be reloaded in time. So I'd very much like to get some shots into the bowels of the ship. So to your left, because you will bump down and stop this ship from doing things. Not quick enough. Slow them down. Honestly, I'm going to try to break my fleet in half. Dismasted by just a sheer volume of round shot. Yep, they are managing to engage me from the front. Engaging Tonant from the stern. Significant amount of guns facing these ships. They're not destroying many guns, surprisingly. Those are a bit too far away. She shoot a round shot, a chain shot, slot to try and slow down some of. Maybe something like this might be in order. Oh, let's do round shot, fire into. Good for a round shot, so we have a right, port and starboard, starboard side. Port side can get it. So they just want to make sure she routes. Beautiful. It's round shot, work, it's chain shot for the rest of you. It'll take a while for me to get my ships turned around. Broadside reloaded, rapido. Might break these guys off. So you try capturing this ship, you all. Chain shot, I think. This ship sail on this side to block up their manoeuvre around here. Separate those two from their ships, from their orders. Shot into that hull, but I also want to fire a chain into there. You hunker down. Who are you selecting from back here? Nobody, but that's your trail. So go like that. There's flagship coming in there. spin this guy around to just fire a round shot. There's a couple of ships here that could do with being destroyed, like a dolphin. Disrupting the enemy's formations. So you guys need to get ready to provide some fire onto this secondary. Yeah, secondaries mean we're going to receive some grief. This ship here, so we've got lots of targets. My admiral's flagship has surrendered. Salamine has been raked. It's got to thread the needle through these spots. It's got these guys to carry on sailing. Now I do want to fire. Tonnets come forward. You are steady, but I want you to knock out the sails of this 4-3. You sail against the wind. Try slowly, ever so slowly, to get into a position. Can you anchor there? Sailing into the wind. You can't really shoot. Surrendered. Fifth in the war against its turn. Sail this way. Still in range. One mast down, keep going. Good, the head of my fleet is starting to come back into the mix. roaring broadside into Maragreta. It's in pretty good shape in a minute. Engaging, firing his guns. The foremast is gone. And the rear mast, good. Let's fire a lovely broadside into that third rear ship of the line. Swedish ships on fire, so it might end up good. Some lovely shots into the mast. We still do have a Diddy mast. This guy fired round shots into the base. This guy keeps firing a chain shot up into the sails. That's quite a nice target. Just stay there. Fire, she's routing. Keep shooting till she quits. She's getting more fire in her own shot. He's routing but not surrendered. Surrender is what we want to see. Keep on sailing just to make sure she doesn't rotate round into a good spot to shoot at you. Get there. Maragreta is trying to turn around, it's not going to work. Keep sailing. Whoop, got a sneeze coming in.
Quelle direction, capitaine?
Arrivé! Solidement arrimé, capitaine. Ordre du navire.
Milord?
Préparez-vous pour la guerre!
Well, I've been chatting away quite happily since the sneeze, and it appears I've not done that. So sorry about that, guys. Hopefully it wasn't that much of a hopefully there wasn't that much stuff you missed. All I said talked about was splitting these ships off to this off to Visby to support this new navy, getting this navy up out of the way for repairs, and sending this army off to engage the Spanish, the Swedish that are there in position. And then this army, when ready, is going to sit here. Well, this army will probably go sit here, ready to hit Petrovskaya. This army will move south, ready to hit, or will hit, St. Petersburg. Yeah, the final war has begun. Okay, so down here in the south, things are okay. We don't need to worry about here for now. You are going to go to Astrakhan. Ooh, we've actually got a little army there. That could be a bit interesting. Take Astrakhan, Don Vosko. You should... You're replenishing, ready to move on to a new target. You are replenishing. You can take a new target. So I might move you up to... Move you up to Petrovskaya, then I will eventually move you up to go retake Arkhangelsk, because I don't think this is going to... Oh no, we definitely would last. So if I run these guys up here...
Préparez-vous! Marchez! Autre chose?
And then let's take these guys and do that.
La victoire sera à nous!
And let's get ready to defend from the Russians, because I've... Well, actually, you know, we'll be sallying out. But I like my odds in a study in this instance. But yes, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you've enjoyed that massive naval battle, and we'll see you next time for the sally of Arkhangelsk.